So I keep getting interrupted, but it makes no difference. Feels so good to be outside, listening to the lake. Pressures of the world. So the Van Gogh Hospital would have like a room for ASMRs, for somebody in deep, deep distress. A soothing, comforting room it would be. Anybody familiar with ASMR? Just amazing. Helped me when I was in my darkest times. And a room filled with, you know, pleasing, comforting things. Fuzzy pillows, comfortable seating, I don't know, just make it as relaxing as possible. Most importantly would be the people. I mean, somebody who's kind, who can respond to anger, if that's the eruption, with kindness and understanding, instead of, I don't know, holding you down and filling your body with drugs. Something as simple as, I don't know, compassion and humanity. That's really what it comes down to for me. My great-grandfather was very compassionate person, and I remember him, and I see the separation. It's pretty much you know, people don't know what to do with people who are out of control, so whatever worked in the past, will got to continue doing it, right? Now, not when we've seen the children who have been treated in the system. Talk to the people who've been Baker Acted in Florida, the kids. Talk to the people on prescription drugs who can't get off of them without having a breakdown, you know, breakthrough, whatever you want to call it. We need a better system. These chemicals aren't cutting it. I run Coalition to End Forced Psychiatric Drugging on Facebook. Just looking over my life. Grateful to be alive. I'm very much the optimist. When I see my future, unless something drastic changes and people start to, I don't know, speak up, I feel hopeless. Yeah. I feel hopeless that I'm not loud enough. I'm not scientific enough. I'm not religious enough. I'm inadequate in this struggle against entrenched ideas. Entrenched ideas of how to best help somebody who has been in crisis, emotional distress, severe crisis, emotional distress. Our current options are the psychiatric ward, at least where I'm at. Some places are blessed with peer respites. So of course I naturally lean towards a Van Gogh hospital in the UP, Upper Peninsula, where I am right now watching the sunset on Lake Superior outside of Silver City, the Porcupine Mountains area. One of my friends committed suicide. I don't know to this day how she killed herself. It was in China. And I pictured her jumping off a mountain in China. Because whenever I think of China, I think of the portrait landscape artistry with the calligraphy, you know, the beautiful picturesque Chinese mountains with snow caps, all done with brush. Anyhow, like everybody else, I've lost somebody. I've lost many people. Not that many people close to me. But I'm 44 now, and I'm sure the day is coming where I'll be like every 70-year-old. Hopefully. Going, yeah, let's read the obit columns and see who we lost today. That's how it is. That's what life is, because life is suffering. But there can be an end to suffering. I should be home doing some Buddhist studies. I'm feeling it today. Basically, that's part. My struggle has been a lot of spiritual stuff. I was very much a Christian when I was a young child. Very adamantly. Well, I don't know how adamantly, but I memorized the Bible stories, parts from the catechisms. I got confirmed. My family was in the church, and things got a little crazy. My parents divorced. I was 12 and 13, maybe. I'm not sure. It was kind of drawn out. And I started drinking. And I wanted to stay away from home. Everything was in chaos as a child. My belief systems weren't there to save me from feeling, or finding, I should say, finding a way out. I would have to say that I didn't start feeling anything until I was probably in my 20s. I kept everything way deep down, and I never really faced the very deep secrets of life, I guess. Still haven't. Always looking for a way to get out. Beautiful view. I'm very blessed. So yeah. Yes, I'm always feeling like I gotta promote my page. If I promoted my page, people listen. No, people can't do anything. I have to take action. So what kind of action? No. I guess I'm taking a video right now. And I'm talking on it. That is an action. That's good. At least I got that over. I'm looking out the window and videotaping. That is an action. I'm listening to my CD. That is an action. I'm smoking a cigarette. That is an action. I'm breathing. So anyway, back to my friend who jumped off the mountain. She didn't jump off the mountain, probably. I don't know how she died. I think I might have asked one of our mutual friends, but I can't remember the response. I don't know. I think I have brain damage from these psychiatric medications that I have been forced to take by the state of Michigan, the federal government, the people in charge, the court system. Which has no option. I want to say that there are options. Peer respites. Not forcing people or ordering people to take drugs when they've been trying to heal naturally and get off of the medications on their own. Sorry, but I don't believe in mental illness. To a point where at least I can function. I don't know. Maybe I can't hold down a job. I haven't tried. I was awarded disability. And frankly, there's nowhere to work up here. I have no way of making the income that I'm getting on disability. Well, maybe there is ways. My boyfriend would say there's tons of ways. I've tried several ways to make some money. The point is, if I had the money, I would invest it into a Soteria peer respite type place with open dialogue, comfort areas, rage areas, grief areas, relevant therapies, sauna, detoxicity, nutrition, maybe a nutrition therapist to help people. Not to the extent, you know, I'm not talking the inner fire where it's $411 a day. I'm talking a simple hotel type place up the road here called Silver Sands Motel. There's one up here. It's empty. It's right across from this beautiful, beautiful place right here. Yeah. I'd like to help people. And the last four times I have been to the psychiatric ward, I feel like I have been tortured. I was force catheterized in an ER. It felt like rape. It was horrific. If there's anything I can do to prevent anybody from going through anything close to what I endured, I must do it. So I'm going to do these YouTube videos, I think. I hope they're interesting enough. I'm not a very interesting person.